Appalachian State enters the season unranked.
They say never, well, I'm saying never. It's going to take a miracle of biblical proportions for this team to make any noise come March. They flew us here to call the opening game, so we might as well see what happens.
And, of course, here's our starting lineup.
I'll tell you one thing. How they start the game is very important and will sometimes dictate how the game is played.
All right, buckle up, folks. Here we go.
And the first half is on the way, baby.
And a momentary look from three-point land. Ball stripped. Now in transition. And now getting set up here in a four round one.
Well, you know, the key, as you said, Brad, is motion. You have to have good movement on the perimeter to set up the guy on the inside. And everything's keyed about the entry to the post player. When he gets the ball, you can run backdoor cuts. You can run screens. You can run back screens. You can do a lot of things.
Swatted away. The shooting guard takes the pass. Pushing in transition. Tries for two.
Good drive right there. Good penetration.
Pushes it up. He fires away. They got it. Well, thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. Ball stripped. The Mountaineers in attack mode. Number zero is called for the foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
He goes to the line. First one is no good. Misses the second shot. On the wing. On the outside. In the lane.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Gave it up. Shoots it. Perfectly executed. Pack rejects it, and we're going the other way. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Around 8 minutes remaining. Top of the circle, can't connect. The point guard handles the feed. For two, not there. The shooting guard receives the ball. Trying to pack it inside. He attempts the jump shot. Missed the jumper. The Racers pushing the ball in transition. For the bucket. There was no doubt about that one. Outside jumper.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Now they work it around the perimeter. With the jumper. And come up short. The shooting guard gets the pass. 7 minutes left on the game clock. He takes a three. Off the mark. Number 12 gets the ball. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. Here comes a pick.
Hey, ball screens are such an important part of the game these days. Guys are so creative when it comes to using that ball screen.
Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
He is going to the line. Makes his first. Second one is no good. Number 23 gets the ball. Goes up for two. Scorches the net. This is the type of guy that can throw the whole kitchen sink at you if you're not careful.
I'll tell you one thing, Brad. This guy's a talent. He can face you up, play back to the basket. He's a good rebounder and a solid defender.
He gets the rejection. Number 42. Slowly, performance has just gotten in his head.
He needs for something positive to happen, which will light his fire and get him going.
About 6 minutes remaining. They'll work it around the arc. Tries for two. He can't get the hoop to fall.
Hey, Brad, this youngster is showing how to put the clamp on a player defensively.
Spectacular defensive effort. That is a dagger in the heart, that shot, Dick.
Hey, they lost focus here. They need a timeout to regroup, Brad.
Timeout, we're all set to pick things up. Number 12 takes the feed. They work it around the perimeter. Two. He buries the shot. And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
Two teams are picking and choosing when they want to push the ball, Brad.
Number 43 picks up the foul. Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, that's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
Hey, I tell you, juniors and seniors are valuable pieces in any college basketball puzzle. Having experienced kids like this on the court and on the bench can take a lot of pressure off the coaching staff.
Got them both.
He converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
5 minutes left in the game clock. Number 23 is whistled for the foul.
Trying to execute on the inbounds.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. He shoots from the baseline. Dick, if you ask me, they're not getting a whole lot of open looks tonight.
They're not moving the ball the way they were taught, Brad.
Pushes it up. He shoots from the deep corner. The missed shot. Number 12 takes the feed. For the bucket, too strong. Challenging like that really makes the offense think twice about putting the shot up.
It's really almost as good as a block.
He shoots from the top of the circle, scores it. He's going to see this guy to sleep tonight, Dick.
He's already living the nightmare, Brad.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. 4 minutes left on the game clock. Number 50 takes the pass. Coach is yelling out the signals. Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. And it's knocked loose. Now on the run. Kicks it out. Tries for two. Goes in. Now trying to feed the low block. For two. They've yet to put together a decent string of good looks at the basket.
Hey, they're getting frustrated and playing right into the defense's hands.
They got it.
Well, you know, if basketball was like nutrition, Dick, his game would be broken down into the two major food groups. That's passing and score.
When you combine those two skills, the floor looks a lot wider for everyone on your team.
I look for something different here coming out of this timeout, Dick.
I wouldn't doubt it, Brad.
They get that rejected. Sinks it.
Out on the wing.
Up and inside.
Number 32, that layup will count for two, plus the harm.
Hey, he sized the defender up and protected the ball going in for the layup. Boy, was that beautiful. I think it's important to get to the free throw line, Brad. It demonstrates that you're playing aggressively and that you're not settling for the jumper.
Tries a three. Nope. He cleans the glass.
The Racers are a balanced team, playing both up-tempo and half-court style, Dick.
Definitely, Brad. They prefer a more balanced style, picking and choosing when to force the tempo and when to settle down in the half-court.
Tries for two, gets it to fall.
We're at the two-minute mark.
Pressure that basketball, help one another, communicate.
He puts up the J.
Hey, when are these guys going to be able to make a shot?
Way out on top, controlling the ball, and it's dripped, active hands.
The Racers pushing the ball in transition.
Throws it up for two.
Change of possession. It's been a great team effort for these guys tonight, Dick.
It's been great to watch them move the ball like that, and they're doing all the things it takes to win. They're committed to playing good team defense, and when your team is doing those type of things, you're smiling as a coach.
The shooting guard gets the ball.
Terrific block shot, though. He's a dominator blocking shots on the interior. Look at that spacing.
For the bucket. Buried it. Pushes it up. He shoots from outside. Bust the J.
One minute left on the game clock. They work the perimeter.
He shoots from the corner. Questionable shot selection there.
Brad, I can guarantee you that he's not the guy they want shooting the ball.
Goes up for two. He gets that one to fall. Cross court. And now there's a whistle and a foul.
Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Misses the first.
You can't miss free throws, Dick. It's going to kill you somewhere down the line.
Well, you got to convert. That's the one thing, like football special situations, you got to be able to execute there.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He misses it. Who wants it? And he saves it. Tries for two. Comes up short. He fires from long range. I know. At halftime, The Racers trail by 21. Appalachian State is showing tremendous accuracy from the floor in the first half, partner.
They're so well coached, man. Working the ball around for the high percentage shot, that's a lot of maturity, man. They really are a mature basketball team.
Looks like a full-court man-to-man press, Mr. Vitale. Pushes it up. In the clear. That, ladies and gentlemen, might really silence this crowd.
That could be the dagger. Clutch shot.
They work it around the perimeter. For two. He missed. Number 43 with the foul. First team foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nestler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
There's a reason they're called free throws, and they can't find the rhythm at the line.
I see a lot of them rushing their shots, Brad.
Foul shot is not good. Not a very good night at the line, Dick.
Absolutely no excuse for that, Brad. No excuse.
The shooting guard receives the pass. Tries one from three-point land. That's an ill-advised shot.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
Blocks the shot. The Racers pushing the ball in transition. Both teams are looking to get something going here. He nails the bucket. For the bucket, you betcha. They are hitting some great shots.
Not a whole lot you can do on defense when they're hitting good shots. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Jumper off the mark. Goes up for two. He comes up empty. Drains the shot. Pushes it up. Tries for two. Missed the jumper. Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock. For two, off the glass and no good. Number 43 is called for the foul, second team foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
At the free throw line. Misses the free one. And, Dick, they just can't seem to find the touch from the line tonight.
Well, no time for lessons, Brad. They got to start knocking them down before it's too late, baby.
He misses the second. Dick, this team is having some serious problems at the free throw line.
And it's a collective effort by all of them tonight.
For the bucket. Drains it. How about the great job of getting to the basket right there, Dick?
Great job of using the bounce to get to the rim. Not too many defenses that can stop that move.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
He manages to keep it in play. And the ball out of bounds, but we'll be staying right here. And let's take a look at a player who's really having a good game here tonight.
I tell you, no, he's been stepping it up, man. He's really come to play tonight. Take a look. What a great performance, Brad. I'll tell you, he's fun to watch.
Well, working it around the perimeter. We're at the 7 minute mark.
Steal, go up the other way, get a layup.
The Mountaineers with the push. He looks at the hoop. He pulls the trigger. These rims are giving them trouble, Dick. They can't get anything to drop.
They couldn't hit the ocean with a beach ball right now, Brad. That was some of my players. That's why I got fired. What an embarrassment.
Hard foul. Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket. Concentrate. Got to concentrate on that free throw line.
It's his second. They've got him right where they want him, Richard. Can't elude the trap.
The man can't get past it, Brad.
And we're going the other way. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover, Dick.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
The center gets the pass. On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up for two. It's good. There's a slam.
Great execution. That's all offensive efficiency at its best.
6 minutes left on the game clock. Moving it around the perimeter. Goes up with it and score it. Looking for a good shot. Tries for two. Doesn't go.
Sometimes you gotta take that whipping, Brad.
Well, the D certainly is tonight. Takes the jumper. Nails the jumper. The Mountaineers have quite a few seniors in their lineup, which definitely is to their benefit.
It is, Brad. Seniors may be the only reason why coaches sleep at night. They rarely make bad decisions, and you can trust them on a court.
Dumps it in. Blocked! Sit down. On the right side. They go with the entry pass. On the post. Turnaround jumper. Gave it up. For three. The missed shot. Pushes it up. 4 minutes left on the game clock. Stolen away. For the bucket. Nice shot. Number 25. On the outside. Goes up for two. That one's off. Number 32 gets the ball. On the dribble, gives it up. They get an open three. Jumper won't go. The small forward handles the feed. Gave it up. Nice move with the face up.
I tell you one thing, Brad. I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing up is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
We're at the 3 minute mark. Down inside. He attempts a jump hook. Can't connect. Pushes it up. Number 31 picks up the foul. Second team foul.
Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
To the charity stripe. He misses the first shot. They're not getting the balls to fall from the line.
Hey, if I were the coach of this team, I would make them run so many lines, I would pass out from watching them run, Brad.
Second one, good. Pushes it up.
They've got him trapped here, Dick.
Hey, they got him in some trouble, Brad.
The Mountaineers have come out here. They're really focused on sharing the ball and really playing pretty good defense, Dick.
I tell you, it's been great to watch these kids really work with one another out there. They all have individual skills to put the ball in the hoop, but that isn't always what's best for a team. Everyone needs to get touches so they can feel involved.
He gives it back to him.
Once again, let's take a look at our star watch.
On the dribble, gives it up, tries for two, sinks the shot.
The Mountaineers are known for playing in the half court, so at this point in the game, things are really looking good for them.
You have to get stops, and you have to execute at the offensive end. Those are two important factors when protecting the lead. It helps even more if playing in the half court is what you do on a regular basis.
Barring some sort of miracle, I think this one could be over, Dick.
It is over, Brad. I'm no math major, but even I can figure this one out.
Two.
He called for the alley-oop. That would have been really beautiful, but he couldn't hang on.
For the bucket. Can't put it down. He just threw it out of bounds. Out of the low block, try to work inside. Oh, yes. Pushes it up. Shoots it. In and out. On the right side. Jumper. And come up short.
1 minute left on the game clock.
He attempts the trifecta. Poor decision there to shoot that three.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nestler. Horrible shot selection.
Gets it to go.
Number 50, 42.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He looks for three. No luck finding the basket the last few trips down court, Dick.
What they need are some easy layups or a couple of nice putbacks.
Whoa, that one silenced the crowd.
He took the life right out of the crowd with that basket, Brad.
Wow, the horrific shooting continues.
Wow, I'm speechless, Brad, and you know that never happens. I don't know what to say. They couldn't be shooting the ball any worse.
Well, we'll see if they've decided to go in another direction with things right here, Dick.
It wouldn't kill them to get a little diversity in their play right now.
Shoots from outside. Missed it.
Loose ball save. And we'll get a change of possession.
Let's take another look at this deep three. Pushes it up. He takes the wide open shot. Off the mark. Appalachian State wins a game that was never really close.
Well, they came into favorites and they did not disappoint.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nestler.